Watching experienced designers reworking designs and providing feedback behind their decisions is one of the best ways of developing your skills faster. Today I have prepared for you an example of mobile app design screens prepared by novice UX and UI designer with the intention of improving them. As you can see, we have four screens from a mobile app dedicated to ordering food. Which brings me to my first tip for all of you out there making similar designs for presentation purposes on services like Dribbble. Three out of four screens in this project were dedicated to sign up and login processes, which are one of the most overused types of screens. One screen of this kind per project is more than enough in my opinion. And I think everyone would appreciate some more interesting examples from you to stand out better. Anyway, let's start with the first screen. There is definitely something that stands out right away. Now, let me show this screen after my alterations and see if you can spot the changes. The thing that stands out is definitely poor contrast and hollowed button, which renders both the service logo and content of the secondary button unreadable. Good photos can definitely elevate your designs, but they are very often containing many shapes and colors, which makes hollowed buttons a very bad idea in front of a photo. Next big thing that you probably notice is that the dimensions of before and after screens are different. The reason behind this is that the original screens, based on their dimensions, were most likely dedicated for iOS and iPhone 8, which as of today is a 5-year-old device. It's not necessarily a mistake, but whenever you're working on design showcasing your skills, you don't really want to present it on outdated tech. Wouldn't you agree? I also replaced a photo for one which is more complementary with the primary brand color and provides better visibility for the service logo. It's time for the next screen. Much of the things I mentioned before will carry over to this one. Again, I will give you a moment to spot the differences. Also, try to recall the reason behind the changes. As in the previous example, we have issues with visibility due to poor contrast, but also something that I think I have never seen before. Semi-transparent text inputs. This is a very big no-no. Potentially you could make it work by blurring the background behind them, but even then it definitely affects accessibility and makes any kind of validation very difficult on the eyes. That's why it's better to separate text inputs by applying unified fill to them and place them on the unified background. Same rule applies to the text buttons, which with improved contrast and increased size are now much more accessible to the potential users. Last thing is the replace photo. As you can see, I was able to achieve a unified background behind the components through utilization of grading for color transition. Let's move to the third example. Similarly to the previous examples, primary issues are around accessibility. I solved them by replacing the photo, providing a smooth transition to unified color of the background and increasing the size of elements. Now, not only we can see the UI elements, but we can properly interact with them. Last small change is around representation for the number of onboarding steps. I mean, come on, how many of them the app like this need? Let's move to the next example. Try to figure out the changes and reasons behind them. Title of the page at the first screen suggests that we are watching page with food categories, but the contents suggest things typically related to breakfasts. Taking that into consideration, it means that we are on the specific category page, so we also need a way to go back to the general categories. Hiding navigation under hamburger tab menus nowadays is considered as not optimal experience for the users. Unless the app contains a lot of items in it, it's better to bring those options forward for faster access. After all, how many navigation elements an app like this needs. Next, I have replaced the icon indicating some sort of a drop-down menu for something suggesting more appropriate action, which in context of this screen would be filtering. Apart from that, I have added grading at the bottom of the screen, highlighting and indicating that it's a scrollable list, and I also adjusted prices to be more believable. Last changes are mostly visual ones, like the background color and slight shadows under the elements. If you like this type of content, you can watch other videos from before and after series here.